Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You're watching for a day. If you're a fan of AOSP ROMs like LineageOS along with some touch of customizations, then Lunaris OS is one of the best LineageOS fork available in the custom ROM world. We already uploaded the in-depth review video of Lunaris OS 3.2 version. Its link is available in the icard and in the video description. Finally, developers released their another amazing update version, Lunaris OS 3.3. which added more custom features, bug fixes, and stability with improvement. All eligible official devices will get the update of this custom ROM. Their list is given in description. But any other devices which didn't have support of this ROM, they can also use the custom GSR version of Lunaris OS. We booted the GSR version of this ROM and did thorough testing of every details in comparison with previous version. Today we are going to review all the new changes of this version, its bug fixes, and at the end of the video we've seen which bugs still exist in this ROM. So watch this video till the end. Now without further delay, let's get started. Let's check out the about device details of this update. This is the Android 16 version based on the QPR0 source code. Lunaris OS version is 3.3, as this ROM is based on the Lineage OS 23 base, which is still under the development, so it have this Lineage OS sister egg. Security patches of this ROM is of latest September 2025. Build date of ROM is of 29 September 2025. Now we'll check out all the new changes of this version in comparison with old V3.2. Though this ROM is based on the AOSP base, but it added some customizations in the ROM to increase its productivity and to improve the user interface of the ROM. In the Singularity customization setting under User Interface option, there are lots of features available. But now we got the new lock and unlock sound similar like other highly customizable ROMs. One new feature I got in this ROM, which is not available in most of the ROMs. This is the toggle named as Music Card, which enables the music card in the volume panel. You can use this as a shortcut to switch between connected audio devices and to change the audio level for any connected devices individually. In the quick setting, we got the new option QS Panel Frosted Blur Effect. This is the normal look of the QS panel and how this looks after enabling this option. Next we get this new legacy quick setting toggle, which converts the new Android 16 user interface of QS panel into the old Android 15 QS panel look. Except that all other old school customization features are available in the ROM, so I will not repeat them again in this video. ROM offers the spoofing feature, but the plain integrity fix is enabled by default in this option. Means you don't have to set up this feature to bypass device plain integrity. I will show you later in this video does the plain integrity is working in this ROM or not. Except this, similar like all other advanced spoofing features are available in this version. Next is one of the unique feature I found in this ROM, which is not available in any of custom ROM I used till the date. This is the advanced performance mode setting. Here we get the toggles like display boost. This will improve the display animations and provide smoother visuals. Next is touch boost. If we enable this, with every touch on the display, it raises the CPU speed, which improves the touch responsiveness. Next are settings related to the CPU boost for little, big, and prime clusters of the CPU. We also get the slider control to individually set the minimum and maximum CPU speed in megahertz. I recommend you to only use this feature if you have some knowledge about the safe CPU frequencies to boost your device performance. Next, under the system option of Singularity customization, we get the quick switch option to switch between Lunaris, Pixel, and Launcher. Next, for Lunaris Launcher, in the recent Stars menu, we got the new toggles to display ZRAM or share button. So in the recent panel, you can check the RAM and ZRAM capacity if you are using ZRAM. And new share button will be available in the recent panel, so you can share app screenshot to anyone by just single click. These are all the new changes I found in comparison with old version of Lunaris OS. If you want detailed review of all the features, please check the video link given in the icard and in description. Performance of this ROM is very good, but honestly, I didn't feel it as smooth as RisingOS 8.1 RTA version, which we reviewed a few days ago. ROM is smooth and have good touch response, but sometimes you may feel jitter and delayed touch response. Let's check out the major bug fixes done by the team in this version. LTE network and voLTE calling is working now. But to make it work, you have to follow a small trick. Its tutorial link is available in description. Next, as I already shown you, in the spoofing setting, play integrity fix toggle is already enabled, means the team have given the inbuilt fix for play integrity. That's why all play integrity checks got passed in this version, similar like old Infinity X3.1 ROM that we reviewed last time. Google Play product is also certified because of this fix. DRM info is showing security level as L1, so you can stream Netflix and Amazon Prime like other streaming media applications at full HD resolution. Punch hole camera cutout misalignment can be easily solved by using the trick that is given in the video description. But still, some minor cutout misalignment will be there, which is negligible. Let's check out some unsolvable bugs. One of that is in the gestures setting, we get the circle to search option, but it's not working even though we install latest Google application. But we have a new working trick to enable circle to search in any stock or custom ROM or GSI. Its link is given in the icard and in the video description. Similarly, Google Assistant is not working, but you can install Google Assistant from the Play Store. Then set the Google as the default assistant in the application setting. Set long press power menu button as Google Assistant. Now it should work perfectly without issues. Under display fingerprint is not working, but you can use face unlock as alternative. Except the major bug of under display fingerprint, everything is working great in this ROM. Especially safety net, which is a big headache for all custom ROMs and GSI users and rooted devices, is got solved in this version. So definitely, I recommend you to try this legendary LineageOS 23 Pro ROM. This is all about for today, guys. Hope you liked our work. Then please do like and share this video. Subscribe to our channel. Press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming content related to custom ROMs, GSI, and Android mods. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.